I want to tell you a little bit about what's been happening in our state and my local, and then in CBA. In Arizona, we focused on one-on-one new educator contacts as well. And what we did not expect to come out of that, because when we made those contacts, it was about getting to know those new educators. We didn't go in there talking to them about KVA or about NEA. We went in there asking them, how do you feel in your new job? What do you need in your new job? What's important to you in your new job? And what we got out of that was 58% of the potential members who are new educators became members. 14% of the new educators who were ESP members, potential members, became members. We can go out and do recruiting, but that's what happened, because we showed we cared about them and we wanted to help them. The things they told us they needed were help with professional development, they were interested in social justice, and they wanted our association to help with that. That's where my local comes in, and that's where all of our locals come in. Jefferson County Teachers Association has a 97% membership. We maintain that every year. But we have to engage all those new educators every year, and we have several hundred of them every year. So what we've done is we've started to create our own Emerging Leaders Program. We've taken some information from the KEA Fellows Program. If you're going to the summit in a couple of weeks, I think there's a session on that. You should go. And we've also gotten some information from Arizona about their eSWAG program and some other new member engagement programs around the younger member engagement programs around the country. And we started creating one of our own. And it's really amazing to see how these new educators think differently than some of the rest of us and where they're going with our association. We've also worked really hard with our member engagement to provide them some other services that they wanted. We've created a new new teacher warehouse. Every single year, we have all the retiring teachers donate whatever's in their room that they're not going to use anymore. They donate it to this new teacher warehouse. And at the beginning of the school year, all the new teachers can come in, and anything they can carry out, they can take for free. If they're not a member, they can sign up right there and go in and take whatever they want for free. So if they're not a member, they pretty quickly become one at our new teacher warehouse. I believe we have some pictures on the screen of our new teacher warehouse. You can see we have hundreds and hundreds of teachers. It's expanded. Some of our local businesses donate materials now. We get cases and cases of pens and paper and all kinds of things that teachers need that they don't realize they need. And sometimes our trash might be a 30-year-old transparency film. There's a new teacher out there who thinks that is the best thing ever, and they're so excited to get it. So we're really happy to be able to provide that to them. We also created a teaching and learning committee in our local that has new educators on it, and that committee with ESSA is becoming even more important as we create a collaborative curriculum and assessment committee in our district to work on what is this really going to look like for kids to get away from the test that we've had so far with those 12 left behind. So these are ways that we're engaging our new educators in my local. But it's important for us to reach out to other locals, and that's where NCBA comes in. As a member of the NCBA Executive Committee, as a regional director, I've been a member of the UMID Committee, the Urban and Minority Issues Dialogue Committee. I've been able to work with Alfonso, who you heard earlier, in creating conversations around social justice and how we can move that out into buildings and into communities. It's not enough for us to just have a conversation at a conference a couple of times a year. We need to have our locals having those conversations in their communities. So we've, through NCBA, created teaching and learning coordinators in every state who are local leaders who can help other local leaders build those committees, those ESSA committees with new educators on them, those community connections through the learning listening tours, and make that happen in their own community. So all in all, the new educator campaign is not just about talking to members, it's about engaging our members. And we engage them through professional developments on classroom management, through social justice listening tours and how they can get involved. We engage them by getting them to be a part of our work, and that's what we all need to do. If you have any questions, come and see me. Thanks for listening.